things that just tear the heck out. Just, you cannot get out on the lake. And we practiced for 3 days, and then the event starts, and we're going into the last day, and I get up in the morning, sun's a long way from being up, and the wind is howling. It's probably blowing 14, 15 miles an hour, which is enough to run you off of this particular lake. And most everyone stays at the south end, and so that's where the wind was coming, and so we're in trouble. But by gosh, I need to go fishing another day. So I know a little ramp on the north end of the lake. Probably take me an hour to get there. And if I can get there, I can be in the north, dark side of the lake, and out of the wind. The wind is blowing out of the north, and so it's hitting the south really bad. So I make my way up to this little spot in Five Fingers, Sam Rayburn Lake. And the sun's still not up. It's starting to get a little bit light, and it's sweet. It is really nasty. It's 35, 37 degrees and sweet. And so I pull into the little ramp area, and I swing my boat around and back over there to the ramp and get out and unhook my boat, take the top off, and it's pretty nasty. But the wind is acceptable. I can get out and fish in this area. Get back in the car, drop my boat in the water, and I went back 1 foot too far. And my boat came off the trailer and slipped out into the lake. Oh, gosh, is that a terrible feeling. It went, oh, I wonder where that exit sign is. And hung up in a tree out there. There sits my boat. And here I am in. The sun, you know, I can see, it's starting to get a little lighter, but the sun's not going to come out, and it is still sleeping. So I've got to get my boat out. There's no one else is going to come to that ramp. I can stay there till noon, maybe, and no one will ever come to the ramp. And there will be no boat go by, because it's just too bad. This is a true story now. Some of the things that I'm going to tell you are not the truth. This is true. There's only one way I can get to that boat. That's swim up there and get it. But I only have one set of clothes. And once I get in the boat, I'm going to be soaking wet. And, you know, I'm going to be in terrible shape. So I park my car. I walk over to the ramp. And I take off all my clothes. I have a pair of boots on that I was going to fish in, and so I had to take them off too. And I got a little pile there, and I took I had a rain suit in the car, and I put it over the pile of clothes. And I'm buck naked. Now, that's a terrible sight, but that's okay. Now look, I'm telling you what the weather like. Did I tell you to sleep? You can't go down to the edge of that water and like put your foot in and maybe get up to your ankles and just start to work your way out, because by the time you get to your knees, you're going to bail on the whole deal. So I took a run in. I did. That's the truth. I just went, you know, I did. There, I had to get that boat. And so I hit it running and I swim out to the boat, and motor is what's hung up in the tree, and that's the best place to get in a boat, is to get back there on the motor, climb up on the motor, and then finally get. So I can't hardly, so it's messed up in that tree, so I can't get in a boat. But I finally hang on and mess around and do one thing or another. I finally get into the boat, start it up, and start chugging. So I'm going to chug into the ramp, and I do, and everything is fine. But when I pulled into the ramp, I imagined what in the world would happen if two old crappie fishermen had just pulled in there, and they're going to look out and see how the wind is, and here's this man sitting in a $50,000 bass boat. Wouldn't that be awful? I thought that could have happened. guys that say, yeah, you know, that looks like the guy I've seen on TV for the last